The arcade project is four classes collaborating to make an actual physical arcade machine.
Game design class, they spend a few weeks developing a prototype for a game.
We're making sort of like a space simulator.
They present their design concepts to Easier Pair Networking, Machining, and Aerospace Composites.
We created build teams with Aerospace Machining and Composites, and then we pitched our idea back to game design, and they chose us for that game.
We have more teams than there are games that are being designed.
Replicating kind of industry standard of sometimes you don't get contracts.
So those students get absorbed into the other groups or the other companies, as we like to say, and then they have 3 weeks to take their design concept and bring it to a full-blown video arcade.
We just started 3D modeling, and that was crucial so that we could actually visualize everything. Okay, so go side view.
Even if we had a hatch, couldn't you guys cut a hole and then put like acrylic inside of it? So it's like basically
window.
Yeah, basically what we're gonna do.
My students have to go out and purchase and acquire and modify electronics.
We gotta figure out how many inches in it's gonna taper down.
Composites and machining have to go and build housing to hold all those electronics.
Our goal is, as composites, is to build the cabinet for the video games.
The cabinet's gonna be like it's a leaning building as if it's like falling and there's like gonna be an alien hanging from it.
My team came up with the concept to make our actual physical arcade make it look like a ship from the game.
Without communication in this, the project probably won't get done.
And we've added new equipment. We have a water jet, we have a laser, and all those have added to the skill sets and also the quality.
Some of their design ideas were maybe great on paper, but not good in practice. In a project like this, they rise to the occasion.
Throughout the course and all the teamwork, everybody comes out better from it.
Going back and forth between classrooms, it's key that we make sure to communicate so that we're all making the same exact design.
Not one person can do everything.
I agree, 100%.
And so they have to learn how to divide the work up and take ownership and responsibility for their specific piece.
I kind of still want it to be like you're being surrounded by the ships.
I think that's like crucial for like the wow factor.
Collaboration is like one of the biggest things with this project.
It gives me like a good experience with working with a large group of people as well as trying to communicate with what our build is supposed to look like.
My team is actually really diverse. We're one of the only teams that have a couple females within it because some of these classes are more male-dominant industries. So it's really important that women and men are working together and collaborating so that we actually get into industry and we know what it's gonna be like.
Students from four different classes that are all very diverse, different skill sets, different personalities, all coming together to cohesively work on one project and kind of simulate what it'll be like out there in the real world once they graduate from high school and move on to bigger and better things.
I'm Hannah Obico. I help do the assembly and manufacture the aluminum.
The students actually have to present to the advisories and they have to stand up on stage, talk about their lessons learned, their struggles, their successes.
This has grown quite a bit since last year. I remember being in the other building in the small classroom looking at the presentations on a very small screen. So when I entered tonight, I couldn't believe how large it had gotten.
Some of the kids will actually get jobs based on how well they do. When they go in an interview, they're gonna say, oh, I remember you from that.
Good opportunity to show myself to the companies that I wanna apply for and stuff, show my work and possibly get myself a job out of it. So it's a good opportunity.
I didn't have anything when I was growing up like this. All we had was wood shop and auto mechanics. I think that was just about it.
I can't even imagine what would happen to me if I got those skills at the age that these guys are getting it. So I think those are invaluable.
The students that are coming through this program are way more advanced than when I came through, and they're just getting better every year.
The time that they allocate here at Pierce County Skills Center for interviewing skills, resume skills, and even doing presentations like tonight will take them many, many places.
This really puts the students in touch with the manufacturing processes that we use. It's a great bridge for either technical education or just jumping right out of the workforce.